Well, it may seem far out, but could psychedelic drugs be the next big thing in mental health therapy? Take a look at this map. All of the states you see highlighted in pink are looking into legalizing or at least considering hallucinogenic drugs to treat all sorts of anxiety disorders.
Well, tonight, Chris Horapsky looks specifically at the active ingredient in magic mushrooms and why some believe someday soon it could be coming to a clinic near you.
This is the psilocybe mushroom, a family of fungi containing psilocybin, a psychedelic drug that can alter consciousness. Civilizations dating back 10,000 years have used it for spiritual connections, which led to an explosion of popularity in the 1960s, and soon after, its federal ban, deemed a Schedule I drug of high potential abuse and no medicinal purpose. But this is all starting to change.
How psilocybin works is very different than any other treatment we currently have for depression.
Johns Hopkins University has been the leader in psilocybin research for 20 years. Their latest study is no exception. It looked at how two sessions of psilocybin, along with psychotherapy, affected a small group of moderately to severely depressed people. This participant's been on antidepressant drugs for 10 years.
It seems to provide sort of like a soft reset. I was able to start thinking differently about the same old situations. There's that meta part of yourself that's sort of watching you do this and saying, you've been trying to do this for years and now you're doing it. And that's just super cool.
Here's what the study found. A month after the so-called trip, 71% of the patients reported a reduction in depression symptoms by at least half. And 54% of the patients were in remission, meaning they no longer qualified as depressed. A follow-up released just this month revealed another surprise.
Remarkably, the rate of treatment response and remission remained quite stable for 12 months after treatment. So that's a pretty remarkable finding, I think. So those big effect sizes that we saw were persistent through 1 year.
There's a growing body of research from other reputable institutions showing similar findings. I'm sure you're asking, how? How does a drug in a wild mushroom ease mental suffering like this? It's something the brightest minds in psychiatry do not know yet. It could be a neurochemical change in the brain, could be an eye-opening matter of perspective for patients. Experts say it's hard to prove, yet.
We're studying how psilocybin changes the brain.
At the University of Minnesota, Dr. Jessica Nielsen's lab is trying to chip away at psilocybin's great secret.
How many participants are you gonna study?
We plan to enroll 46 total.
And how many applied?
Close to 1,000 so far.
Her team is taking MRI brain scans over time of people after taking psilocybin, trying to find the drug's window of therapeutic opportunity.
So the hypothesis is that psilocybin is putting the brain into what we would call an adaptable state. This is a term called neuroplasticity. And so that it makes the brain able to change.
Do you think it should be legalized?
For medicinal uses, absolutely.
Today, psilocybin remains highly illegal, though the Food and Drug Administration recently deemed it a breakthrough therapy, a term given to drugs that show a clear advantage over available therapy. And a lot of businesses are banking on it being rescheduled for use in clinics.
This is our treatment room.
Dr. Manoj Das is co-founder and medical director of a St. Paul clinic called the Institute for Integrative Therapies, one of the first in the state to offer psychedelic therapy 15 months ago.
We see people from ranges of depression, anxiety, various forms of trauma.
Here, they offer patients ketamine, a dissociative anesthetic that can produce psychedelic experiences, approved by the FDA in 2019.
This shift in perception is like looking at yourself like a bird in the sky. Instead of being in the forest and walking through the forest and being sort of lost, you can now rise above it and see your life in a totally new perspective. This is just the beginning using ketamine. We're going to be doing clinical trials with psilocybin coming up and MDMA coming up too. We just expect the demand to skyrocket.
Could this shroom boom lead to a revolution in mental illness treatment? These experts have a dose of skeptical optimism. But it's early yet. The trip has just begun. Chris Horapsky, Care 11 News.
Well, not everyone is on the psychedelic bandwagon yet. Dr. Joseph Lee, president and CEO of Hazelden Betty Ford Foundation, told Carol Levin this. Many substances, like opioids, for example, are helpful medicines and also have risks. Psychedelics show promise in early research, but we still have a lot to learn and real risks to avoid.